wrong? Did you see?
Yes.
What is wrong? The abbreviations doesn't match with the name, labels, right? This should be volume. Okay? This should be volume. And the second one should be slope. Okay, please change the labels and then save the data. What is correlation?
Ya ben de çekeceğim.
Can you say something about correlation?
Yok, yok, nereye koyacağımı bilmiyorum.
What does it mean? The relationship between two variables or two data. So,
yok, 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 yok.
What should the data type be? Which type of the data? Continuous. In fact, we can investigate the relationship between all type of data. But for your concern, we just deal with continuous data. Okay? Continuous variable. There are two types of correlation coefficient. One of them is Pearson correlation coefficient. The another one is Spearman's, right? Pearson and Spearman correlation coefficients. Two type of correlation coefficients, right? Pearson and Spearman. They are already in SPSS, okay? Suppose that we have two variables like on the screen. We are dealing with the relationship between two variables. What is relationship between two variables? For example, if one of them is increasing, yes, the change of one variable should affect the other one, right? If one of them is changing, then the another one should be changed, right? In this example, the blood volume affects the blood flow, okay? And we are dealing with the relationship between these two variables. First of all, we need to check the normality assumption to decide which type of correlation coefficient should be calculated, okay? First of all, let's do together, let's check these variables' normality.
Analyze, descriptive, statistic, explore.
From analyze and descriptive statistics and then explore, right? I think all of you memorize these steps. Put these two variables to the dependent list. And from plot section, select normality plots with test, okay? And continue and okay. From Shapiro-Wilk test results. From Shapiro-Wilk test results. The p values are less than 0.001, right? These p values are almost zero, but not exactly zero. They are less than 0.001. And also, less than 0.005, right? And what should be our decision in this situation? Are these variables distributed normally or not?
Not.
If the value is less than 0.05, then the variables don't distribute normally, okay? Assume that they distribute normally. If both of them distribute normally, then you calculate Pearson correlation coefficient. Okay, the parametric correlation coefficient is Pearson. Parametric correlation coefficient is Pearson. And non-parametric version is Pearson. Okay, let's calculate this correlation coefficient. Probe, analyze, and correlate. Select B variate. Okay? Put both of them. Put all variables to the variables section. As you see, by default, Pearson is already selected. If our variables distributed normally, then we would calculate.